Boycast.
Oh my god, the Germans. Okay, time to just commentate in German, yeah.
No.
Alright. Yeah.
Alright.
Alright.
Awesome.
Menti, it is time to start for you.
Sure. Welcome back to 3WC. This is Netherlands against Brazil. Lower bracket, actually. Maybe slightly expected for the Netherlands. I don't think anyone expected Brazil to already be in lower bracket, though.
Yeah, definitely. Hello, my name is Rizova, and I'm joined by Menti as well. Wow, amazing. Two Germans. And yeah, Brazil, Netherlands. Netherlands lost 2-6 against France, if I recall correctly. Also being 16th in qualifiers. And Brazil lost 5-6 against China in a very, very close and competitive match. So it'll be interesting to see how both teams will face each other. Especially how both of the teams that have beaten them already played 2 hours before.
Yeah, so I mean, if you look at the matchup that Brazil had, you'd expect them maybe to lose because, you know, it's China. China is really, really strong, as we saw like 2 hours ago. But damn, everyone in the prediction, like in the prediction before the tournament started, was saying, yeah, Brazil is like a top one contender. And they're already lower, so it's just really interesting to see this contrast. But I don't think anyone will deny that Brazil is coming into this one as a favorite. And I think an upset would be very surprising to say the least. But I mean, the Netherlands don't have a terrible roster. Like, they have some really strong players, so I wouldn't be surprised to see them take a couple points at least.
If not, I can also see that. Also, Brazil, I mean, the match, we already talked about this 2 hours later, 2 hours earlier, when we talked about China. The China vs. Brazil match was just incredible. Like, you pretty much only saw 2-3 FCs. Even like, I think there were like 1 or 2 SS scores in the match as well.
Yeah,
Brazil just being extremely strong on their own picks, and especially with pretty much anything DT, are incredible. Hard Truck is really good for them. Nissan with the DT1 SS last round. That team is definitely gonna try to just maybe even roll over Netherlands, but Netherlands also showed a lot of good scores against France. So
yeah, I mean, a China versus Brazil matchup early stage is just honestly a 50-50 on the day. So
yeah.
I mean, the scores were really high, so I mean, but one of the team had to lose, you know? So like, yeah. Both teams can win, even if they both have seen every map. But as we get into the bans, a number 2 ban from Brazil, I think that makes sense. Netherlands are like pretty good, like in general, have some very strong stream players.
Yeah, so it was their strongest placing as well in the qualifiers.
Yeah, so it makes sense.
2.84 million, so they pretty much have a free way of C.
Yeah, if you go as a relatively clear favorite into a match, at least on paper, you want to be shutting down your opponent and what they can do well, because if you are really that good, you can probably still do well even on the maps you're not the best at. And a pretty expected ban from the Netherlands here, Hidden 3, the low AR in map.
Especially with Hidden just being a general weakness from the Netherlands.
Yeah, Brazil
makes sense.
Yeah, Brazil has some very competent Hidden players, so it doesn't surprise me to see that.
Yeah. I mean, you have sometimes Nissan on the Hidden, you have Mistia, you have Korean Maluku, and you have also Serbs, who are also on Tusk. We're all 4 just really, really good on the Hidden.
Lucas Subs. Yeah, Subs is just really... It's just a really nice player to have on your roster, because even though you have that core 3 of, you know, Korean, Nissan, and Mistia, If one of them doesn't feel it, Zubs can probably just fill in whatever as well.
Yeah.
And then you just have the two specialists on Brazil. So that's also why people thought like immediately this team is going to be a contender. And while they are in the lower bracket, they did show, as we said before, some incredible performances as well on certain maps. So it's just a really hard team to find anything to pick against because they're just really good at everything. With Hardock One coming out from Brazil as a ban, I think that's a little bit interesting, actually. But not incredibly surprised at the same time.
All right. Yeah, we can see them pretty well. Oh my god, Roselia!
Oh my god.
At Cementi.
Number 6 ban from Netherlands as well, coming out of the second one. I think that's very, very... makes a lot of sense. If you're banning Hidden 3, you probably just want to ban...
Actually, well. Very interesting ban from Prezo with Hardock 1.
Yeah, I was a bit surprised by Hardock 1, just because it's like one of the harder maps, just because it's a little bit awkward.
Yeah, that's probably the case for them.
Yeah, but I think Netherlands is like, they're more of a mechanic-centered country, I feel. So maybe they just want to ban the Hard Rock mechanic pick and leave the slightly more niche picks in Hard Rock open instead.
I mean, the Netherlands are surely not too dominant on the mechanics against Brazil.
Yeah,
so it'll be interesting if they actually just go for it straight up, or if they maybe just go for a different strategy.
I would be surprised if they go for anything else besides just picking their best maps and hoping that Brazil can't map. Hidden 2. That's definitely not what I was expecting.
Yeah,
but So the Netherlands tried to throw my entire line of reasoning out of the window. The map I had at least expected them to pick.
Yeah,
that's pretty awesome.
That is a very, very interesting pick. Yeah. I'm interested to see what.
Yeah, maybe they just have good scores on the sheet. Like, how would you know, right? Like, we're speaking from our own personal experience, but maybe they just have 3 FCs on the sheet.
Yeah, maybe. We'll see Walter, Skyrovania, and Heitneuter for Netherlands and Korean Luko. I guess 2 other players. I don't know if Tones and XX Lewis are gonna play this map.
I know pretty good at Hidden, so I wouldn't be surprised. I am a little surprised to not see Zubs, actually, because I know Zubs is a flow aim Hidden enjoyer.
I mean, there's also Mistia, so...
Yeah, I mean, it's the thing with Brazil, they have so many good players that it's like, it's kind of hard to decide, but yeah, there we go. Tonus actually leaves and Zubs enters the lobby.
Yeah, there's the Lucas.
Zubzada.
Zubzada.
But yeah, I mentioned him specifically because I just remember that his Hidden flow aim is really, really, really consistent.
The guy is kind of good on Otsu.
He is. Yeah, from personal experience, from playing with and against him, so.
Yeah, and XX Lewis actually going for this map, probably. And we don't see Nissan or the other Nissan, also known as Mistia.
Yeah. And all these 3 players in Brazil are super, super good on Hidden in general, so I'm not too surprised. Maybe they just feel it a little bit more than the others.
Yeah. I mean, I'm just looking at the last Flow Aim Hidden map that they've played, and Mistia was seeing that with 7100, so I expected him to play this map, because both Selps and XX Lewis did not play the last Hidden Flow Aim map in round of 16, so it'll be interesting to see how they are doing.
Yeah.
But I mean, also Subs. I don't know if he was even there.
Got a last minute replacement going on with Tones coming in instead of Korean, so.
Yeah.
the three players that, you know, are not part of that core trio that we mentioned at the start. So that's quite interesting. I mean,
yeah, it's interesting, definitely.
I'm not incredibly surprised because I would assume that like all players on Brazil can play this well. I just know they're really good at this type of stuff. So
yeah,
maybe it's really just a feeling thing for them in this map in particular. And it, I mean, especially on Hidden Flow Aim, it can often depend on feeling because it's such an easy skill set to find misses left and right if you're, you know, having an off day.
Yeah, definitely. There's also like a double powered in this map. I think somewhere in the middle that can catch you off guard really easily.
Yeah, mostly Flow Aim, a little bit of that techie style with these sliders, but the main emphasis definitely on just Flow Aim. We see these patterns with like that slightly expand.
Yeah, Dolter with the first break for the Netherlands.
Yeah, giving that early advantage over to Brazil, especially because of the Ak as well. We see Zub still with the forbidden cursed Ak. XX Luis finds a break though, so equalizing in terms of combo, especially now with Tones missing actually. That's gonna give it over back to the Netherlands.
Yeah, I'm just surprised to see those players in Hike Noita matching it though. So yeah. It's only subs against Skyro.
Yeah, Tones with another break though, so that combo advantage is staying on the side of the Netherlands, although barely.
Alright, the double part is coming up. Maybe it catches someone off guard. Hopefully it's not subs.
My eyes are glued on the side of the screen, I'm not gonna lie. And Skyrovania finds the first break and Lattice FC for the Netherlands is also gone. So, combo advantage back to Brazil and it's kind of close, but I just want to keep watching Zobs, man. What the hell?
This guy is...
Guys,
hit the doubles!
Gaming. Tones misses again, but it doesn't matter too much, I think. Skyrovania with another miss, combo advantage back to Brazil, Tones another miss. Oh, they're trading misses on the players that keep missing. Hike Noiter, Dolter, XX Luis holding. As I said, that Hike Noiter does break. Zubs drops the SS, unfortunately.
Yeah.
Luis drops the combo most importantly though, but Zubs also misses. But Dolter and Hike Noiter as well.
Yeah, there's not enough time for Alter, so this is gonna be the first point for Brazil, the first breakpoint as well, as this was Netherlands' pick.
Yeah, Zobs has that's kind of a good score.
That is a decent score, not gonna lie. 1-100 to 150 is really, really good on this map. I was kind of holding back with a comment on saying that maybe we will see someone match Nope KJK's replay on this, because he FC'd like... He SS'd the entire map and then slider broke on the last slider. But looking at subs, I guess it is doable that someone could potentially match that really good replay from him.
Yeah, Zobs, super, super strong ack. Unfortunate slider break, but that was actually kind of close as well. Like,
yeah.
It was a 100k difference, so. But nonetheless, that's a break point for Brazil. So they can already secure themselves a solid lead with a good first pick here. I do wonder what Brazil's gonna go for here, because I was expecting Brazil to go for more of these, you know, like, hidden, slightly gimmickier picks. But I guess not. We'll see what they go for here. Really. What are you expecting, Brazil? What's,
I do kind of think that Brazil is probably gonna go for... they have... some decent picks. They could potentially go with something like a hidden one. They could maybe go with something like a Nomad 3, a Nomad 4.
Potentially.
Maybe also 3-mod 3 or 3-mod 1. Brazil has a lot of options. I don't think they will go for something mechanically intense yet.
Yeah, I kind of agree, because I know the Netherlands are pretty decent mechanics, so maybe not wanting to pick into their skills. But yeah, I agree as well that Brazil has a lot of options here. And as you say, they just picked ET1.
Good. Okay, we both got absolutely fucking destroyed with any of our assumptions.
Yeah, 51 addictions, 10.3, 240 BPM. It is a little bit bursty, burstier than you'd expect from a modern DT1 type of map.
Yeah, it's one of the more speedier DT1s.
Yep.
Also, slightly popular among anyone who plays Nick tournaments.
Yeah,
I think he's the sole reason why this map is probably now overused.
I remember it being in the most recent tournament that Nick hosted in qualifiers. I mean, it's a very solid DT1, right? Kind of.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean, Nissan coming in, Corbion coming in, XX Louis staying. I think it's a pretty expected roster. It's not a Brazil DT pick if Nissan's not in. I've spotted a brony. I will now cheer for Brazil.
Let's go. My man.
Oh my god, there's a second one. Jesus Christ.
Let's go! This is just a lol of the Netherlands.
Oh well. Yeah, Mr. Brony NL 1.
Brony
and
Mr. NL 1.
Who, do you happen to know who is who?
I think Brony NL2 is OPAP.
Okay.
I think Luciano and Brony NL is...
Brony NL2 is Luciano, yes.
And Brony NL is probably... no, not Vivellium, right?
Oh no, I don't think he's playing.
Oh, it's Manivet, yeah, okay.
Ah, I see, Manivet, understand.
Yeah.
Man, these people with their funny name changes, feels it's fine now with three lolos. Netherlands are two bronies. Ah, I've had enough. I just want to read out the names, man.
Alright, we are getting into DT1. This pick is going to be very favored towards Brazil, kind of. I mean, not favored, but... Brazil has an incredible DT roster, or DT1 roster.
Yeah, I mean, they have an incredible DT roster.
Yeah.
So, I mean, not too surprising that they ended up picking this.
Yeah, let's see who's gonna SS this time.
No one.
Korean Maluko.
Okay, yeah. I mean, Mr. Manivat with the first pick. I'm not playing the team, man. And we go into the first guy, only Manivet's missed so far. Everyone else holding with pretty good ACK actually. Like the lowest one is actually Manivet, but except him it's Igniter with 98, so pretty good so far.
Oh, Korean Maluko.
Oh, forbidden ACK.
Sorry, but still loving the man. Oh, Bernie and L2. Or Luciano.
Very good. That's what I want to hear. But yeah, good break. So, probably Igniter there here with DFC and a low ACK one as well. So, can't really match too well with, you know, the entirety of Brazil.
Yeah. The lowest ACK being Nissan OX is Louis actually breaking there.
Yeah, but.
I mean, it doesn't matter.
Yeah, he gets matched by Luciano here. So, Brazil still comfortably in the driver's seat here.
Belly, no SS though this time. Unfortunate. But the ACK is incredible from Brazil.
What?
Korean.
What? He misses right
after Maluko.
He misses right. He misses right after the break, but
I mean Brony now, yeah.
Yeah, it does
Bronies. No Bronies missed.
Yeah, it still just take Igniter with the FC, but it's just not gonna be enough with Nissan still holding 99.3.
And Nissan just doing Nissan things.
Yeah, and at this point, it's simply just there's not enough time for a comeback, even if Nissan were to miss. So,
I mean, it's not gonna break. So,
solid pick for Brazil, yeah. Closes out with an FC as well. Pretty good ACK in classic Nissan fashion.
Yeah, Korean Maluko kinda trolling there. Maybe got some donation going, but. Also, Hake Noita with the 94 FC.
Yeah, I mean, FC is an FC. Outscored all the other people that missed.
Yeah, that's true. Players. Yeah.
But nonetheless, a pretty solid pick from Brazil. So, ball in the court of the Netherlands here, trying to pick themselves back up and not let Brazil run away with this too quickly here.
Yeah. We will just see how Netherlands will respond to that. Hidden 2 pick. It was interesting. It was not, I mean, obviously nothing that we expected at all, but it was close. It was
definitely
within reach for them. So they may actually go for a slightly different strategy than what they would normally do with just going for mechanics. Instead, they will maybe go for something else.
Yeah. I mean, it's mostly that it's not like they, I don't think it's they don't trust their mechanics. It's just that they're against Brazil and Brazil's kind of good at that.
But, yeah. Oh yeah, also mentioning apparently fucking Maniba is playing next to Ekora right now.
Oh yeah, because Ekora is place, right?
Yeah, Wu's so, place
at least.
Yeah,
that's a little of a funny circumstance there. I have commentary from Ekoro.
Yeah, let's just hope that Ekoro doesn't like go in for
Can you imagine Ekoro just joins the cast, you know, oh yeah, Maniba just missed, and 2 seconds later on stream it actually shows.
My man missed. Quite a blunder.
Quite a blunder. But yeah, Netherlands taking their sweet time here with the pick. I guess it's kind of hard as well to pick against Brazil, you know, especially if you come in to the match as the underdog. And we are going to see Fremod 2 here. So the CS4 R9 kind of stream map. Told this map's a little bit easier in comparison to the rest of the pool, so maybe trying to just go for a map that they know they can three-way and hoping that Brazil does not.
Yeah, this map is slightly streamy, AR9 density, old mapping sort of from CRN.
Yeah,
Yeah, this is probably a map that you would probably go into Hard Rock, most likely for the Netherlands, who will probably go a 2 or even 3-way Hard Rock on this.
Yeah,
Brazil could go for something else, maybe a Normod, but I think mostly it's just gonna be Hard Rock as well for them.
Yeah, it's the type of map that, like, because we're still in quarters, it's not gonna push skill cap just yet, even if you pick Hard Rock. So that you'd rather pick Hard Rock overhead than just to avoid that awkwardness on AR9 and just fully put the strain on mechanics.
Yeah, if you just go Hard Rock on this, it's pretty much just turns into a somewhat oldish mechanic kill map, and that's pretty much it.
Yeah.
So anyone who's gonna go hidden, I mean, it's gonna be interesting if anyone actually goes for hidden. We need a third Brazilian.
No, Brazil has decided they're just gonna play with 2 players, actually.
Alright. XX, Lewis, and Korean Maluku.
Oh, subs.
They will tear it up.
Dubs would be someone I would expect to actually go hidden on this. But
probably that's a name out for him. I don't know.
And he's actually joining. Alright. So.
Oh, XX, yeah. Lewis just.
I mean,
oh,
I have.
Oh, it's subs.
I'm expecting Hard Rocks.
Yeah.
Maybe we'll be surprised. Maybe someone actually goes hidden.
I think it's probably gonna go for something like Korean Maluko, Hard Rock, Nissan, Nomad, and then maybe subs hidden.
Yeah, maybe. I mean, Nissan is really known to just be comfortable on, like, you know, old style mapping. Specifically on the T, but like, I wouldn't be surprised if it takes a mod. But
yeah,
no, it is no mod from Nissan.
Actually, also only one Hard Rock from the Netherlands.
Oh yeah, so no overmods, and they actually choose to go one hidden each, which is, I mean, if you're comfortable, why not, right? But
yeah,
I mean, not looking super comfortable. The ulter drops a couple misses at the very first pattern, but maybe it's just getting accustomed to the map.
And maybe Subs is gonna SS, or nearly SS once again.
No, don't curse
my
it.
Guy.
Not yet, at least. Patience, my brother.
This time we won't curse anyone in this match.
Less?
Unless.
But yeah, besides that very early break from Dolter, I think actually Korean broke as well. Because his combo is ever so slightly lower than everyone else's, but let's pretend also, they're all at seas.
Also, the Ak advantage was the Netherlands. Luciano just kind of misaiming that stack.
Yeah.
Or under-aiming.
First, like, relevant miss of the map so far. Everyone else holding their respective combos, and yeah, now the advantage is in for Brazil, but Nissan misses.
That was a miss that you don't expect from him.
Yeah,
especially on something pretty free, because that was literally just a normal jump.
Yeah, just unlucky.
But Subs and Korean Maluku just going off for their team.
Yeah.
Oh no, the jumps.
The advantage is actually on the side of the Netherlands right now in terms of combo, especially because Nissan also dropped a bunch of back. As I say that,
the the only FC for Netherlands drops.
Yeah, and this might seal the deal unless we see both Korean and Zubs missing, because the map's actually about to end already.
Yeah, we go into the last stream section. Maybe something happens here, but besides Brony and L and Nissan trading their misses, nothing happens here.
Yeah.
Subs with DFC. 100.
Really solid act from Subs. Once
the
again.
Guy.
150 actually.
I mean, Subs, what did you do there?
The silly little goose.
Silly really little Norwegian.
Very solid score there from Zubs. Very unfortunate 50, actually, more than anything.
Yeah.
But, yeah, converts that second breakpoint, actually, for Brazil. And it really just looks like Brazil's going to run away with this one unless the Netherlands can put a stop, like, within the next 2 points. Yeah, like, Brazil might just keep going with the DTs, honestly. They had better act in general as well on DT1. Well, even though it is mostly a Jama, it has those bursts, and yeah, I think something like a Nomad 5 or DT2 could actually be in their favor, just because...
I really want to see a DT2, please. I haven't seen this map.
Has it even been played so far in the weekend?
I don't know. I actually don't think so.
From the matches I've watched, at least nothing. But
yeah,
maybe
same.
I missed.
Yeah, Poland banned DT2.
Shameful display.
Yeah.
Almost three, actually. So they do go with Anemone here. So that's...
We will see the map that Nauts won't ever want to see again.
Oh yeah, not
it's
really.
It's old like sport and old.
Yeah, it's got a lot of... It's got both snap and alt, so it's a nice little mix of both. Not the easiest map. Like,
yeah.
We did only see one FC in the China and France match, since it's very easy to just miss aim a little pattern or whatever. And, I mean, you know, I think of Brazil... I think of Nissan, I'm thinking he's gonna single tap the entire map, actually.
That would be quite interesting. I mean, we can't rule anything out. Solely thinking about China 3-3, so...
The double easy gambit.
I'm still in shock. Why would she ever go twice easy on that map?
Sure. But I mean, if I see Nissan, like, there's no way it's not gonna single tap. Yeah, exactly. Like, the BPM is probably still fine for him. And, I mean, he's a notorious single tap slash speed.
There's no way he's gonna single tap this.
Oh, he's gonna single tap. He's in for the ult map. He's gonna single tap. It's just how it is. And yeah, I mean, Korea and Maluko and Luis are also just really solid ult players, so not surprised to see them here.
I mean, I'm still kind of surprised to not see Mistia yet in any map.
Maybe it's just not around or it's not feeling it too much. Could be both.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, on the side of Netherlands, we have Manjevat, Luciano, and Hignoiser.
Yeah, no changes compared to DT1.
Yeah, actually, it's the same lineup as DT1, funnily enough. Even though the maps are completely different.
Yeah, same with Brazil, actually.
Need to investigate this one.
Yeah, it was. It was Luis, Nissan, and Korean.
Yeah.
It's exact same lineup for both teams.
Kinda
even though it's an entirely different map. Okay, that's gonna be interesting. I mean, we will see Nissan alternate, so...
No, he's gonna single tap, trust me. Bet.
I do not believe. He's not even gonna load in. We won't ever see it.
It's over.
We will never see. Oh no, oh no, I'm only seeing one key. Oh no. Oh no, he actually is.
I don't know.
Okay, yeah. I didn't expect that. I didn't expect that he goes fucking Germany mode.
He actually, I think the most impressive stuff, it's not like he's doing the thing where he switches, you know, fingers to single tap. He actually just he uses this K2 every time. It's kind of crazy. As we get over Nissan single tapping the map, Hignoiter did find an early break, so
yeah.
Very early advantage here for Brazil.
And we will see a great axe for Brazil again, just like France.
Yeah.
Wow. I'm actually kind of impressed by the single tap.
You're also just staring at the screen, aren't you? Meanwhile,
yeah, I'm literally just looking at this key overlay while we are doing that. Both Hectic Lewis and Hignoiter break.
Yeah,
it's two FCs against two.
Yeah, slight advantage still for Brazil just because XX Lewis had that like slightly bigger combo when he broke.
Yeah, and Korean Maluku is still holding onto the SS. Still, yeah. Lewis breaking again, so.
Yeah, that's a very slight combo advantage over to actually a little more than slight. Never mind. No combo.
All right, the best act, the best score for Netherlands just dropped here.
Yeah. So two FCs against one in favor of Brazil right now. So looking good for them. Nissan looking comfortable as ever on his single tap journey. Korean Maluko is still holding the forbidden act. We shall not mention it until it actually drops.
Yeah. Okay, good job. We didn't mention it, so.
Oh, we're just so good at this. It's.
Yeah, we are literally so strong today. It's insane. Can just every team just play today?
Yeah. As we get into the big second key, this is crunch time. Especially for the Netherlands, any misses as we see. Jesus Christ, I'm so sorry.
Anyway, and Hignoiter.
So the last.
Oh!
Whatever. You know,
yeah, Brazil, thank you for 4-0 now. Nissan and Korean Maluku going really off on this map. Well, Netherlands is. Oh, I'm sorry, Korean Maluku, for that. Nissan! I did not believe in you, but you. I actually.
He's just single tapping. I mean, everyone else broke at some point. Luis is the only one that's actually building up any sort of combo. And Nissan's.
Yeah. While his initial struggles in the first Ki, where he pretty much broke on every pattern.
Yeah, and
like Hignoiter breaking again.
Nissan's actually cruising. Like, this is another day in the office for him.
Just the second FC for him.
Korean and Luis break, but it really doesn't matter when Nissan's holding an FC and Brazil has 700 Ki score advantage over the Netherlands.
The guy actually just single tap FC the entire map. I'm impressed.
Yeah, it's pretty. He's pretty good at the game, I think.
Yeah, he can click the circles at a pretty good rate, so.
But yeah, that's gonna give Brazil the fourth point on the board, and it's looking really dire for the Netherlands. The only pick that was actually, like, kind of close was hidden two. Everything else was more or less decisive for Brazil, and that's more than anything, that's what's to worry about, really. Like, you need to find something where there you can at least, you know, try and fight for a point. But it's not looking very good for them as of yet.
All right, we'll see how Netherlands are gonna go with this pick now.
I would like to see a curveball thrown.
I would like to see the G-Sack.
I just want to see something different because everything they kind of haven't gone for. Like, everything they've gone for so far hasn't really worked out. So,
time for another one.
Yeah, it's time for another one. Hell yeah.
It would actually be such a double one pick.
I love the content map, guys.
I love nearly 5 minutes of Roselia.
Yeah.
Alright, let's see what they actually go for.
Taking their time once again.
Yeah. Admittedly, it makes sense considering how they didn't really look that good on their picks before.
I mean, in general, it's just kind of hard to pick, right? You're facing Brazil. They got free! So they go for
it. The Kimono Princess, CS6.5, pretty much only aim. With some weird triples, if I recall correctly, but overall, it's probably one of the, maybe even the easiest Hardrock map in the pool.
Yeah, it's barely over, like, I think just about 2 minutes, and it's really just mostly focused on the aim. There's some awkward angles, but on precision, it's not that big of a deal. It is base AR8, so, you know, not on Hardrock would it be a little bit awkward, but on Hardrock it is really just all about precision aim, really.
Yeah, looking how Brazil actually struggled a bit on the Hardrock 3 last round, even though it is pretty much a different map, somewhat. It does make sense that Netherlands actually could go for this now, so We'll see how they will do.
Brazil also banned Hardrock 1, which is like, it has its, you know, its quirks, but in the end of the day, it is still like Hardrock consistency with some aim.
Yeah.
So maybe they're just trying to exploit that and the fact that this map is, you know, if you can play it, you'll probably kind of see it.
Yeah, pretty much. Like, this map is not really that difficult to FC.
Yeah. I guess you have, you know, the base aim to play it. We see Korean Maluko in actually the same roster as last map for Brazil so far, at least. Meanwhile, Manjevat leaving for Skyro. So just one change on the side of the Netherlands.
Yeah, we will see the Skyrovania. Hopefully no mappers will be attacked.
Nice.
I'm just kidding.
It took me a second to...
I'm just kidding.
So toxic. Anyway, into the precision pick.
Yeah.
It's a short one, so misses will actually matter, especially once we get to that like 200 combo, which is close to the middle of the map.
Let's see who's gonna break for the first time. Oh, Nissan, sorry.
Nissan with the super early break here. It's 20 combo in, so surely it's not gonna be...
Yeah, I mean, to be fair, he did have his struggles so far in the tournament with precision on Hardrock. He didn't do too well on the Hardrock 3 last round.
It's not his main skill set, obviously. I think if... I mean, I'm just gonna assume that Misty is not around, which is why Nissan is playing it, because otherwise I'd say that Misty would probably be in for this.
Yeah.
So far, everyone holding super well. It's really just that early break and the ek advantage in the favor of the Netherlands keeping them.
Yeah, that's why they have a really good lead so far in this map.
Yeah. Oh!
Luciana, though, the main Hardrock player in the team.
Yeah, with an unfortunate slider break, so it's gonna slowly but surely go over back to Brazil if everyone keeps holding their combos.
Yeah, maybe no one gets caught by the slider. Okay, gladly. That slider actually sucks when you side reads. I remember that I just broke so hard in that. Oh, X-Lewis though, with the break, but Hank Neuter matches it.
Yeah, traded right away, so advantage still on Brazil's side.
So as long as both Korean Maluku and Nissan hold, this will go for to Brazil again.
Yeah, it's ever so slight advantage for them, but you know, enough. Especially with the two FCs or two near FCs. I'm pretty sure all of Brazil actually broke like at the same spot.
Yeah. Korean Maluku and Nissan, yes. They have the exact same combo, wow.
Yeah, they literally broke like a 10 combo in at the start. I think XX Lays also did.
Yeah.
That's actually very funny.
Yeah, actually, in terms of like, Tab was on 4-3.
But yeah,
my guy did not see the circles. My guy did actually not see the circles on that then.
But yeah, Brazil take that third breakpoint in a row and looking to finish it up with a sweep, unless the Netherlands can muster up something different here, because so far it's really been looking pretty easy for Brazil, honestly. It's been looking super solid in most maps, really. Like, Kaden 2 was actually the only map that was, you know, could have gone either way. Everything else was quite decisive.
All right, let's see how Brazil is gonna maybe finish the match already.
Yeah, I think Brazil has a lot of picks, as we can see from that roll 3.
All right, man, they are just showing off. Okay, maybe probably, a Nomad. Nomad 5, Nomad 2.
Probably just can't decide on a map because they all feel good on it. A DT4.
Oh, DT4. I might have counted extremely wrong there, but it's okay. DT4, yeah, this is pretty much the spy, but harder. It's indoor Kainada track maker.
I can't say I was expecting this pick in particular, but it's also not, you know, completely outside of the, like, completely out of the question. Because it is a map that Brazil can probably play very well.
I mean, looking at how they did on spy, they played that map really well, with nearly 3 million on it, and it's pretty much just a tiny bit harder, but pretty much just the exact same map. Same BPM, same AR, same sort of mapping style. So this is pretty much just a pick that Brazil was waiting for.
Yeah, it's like slightly modern type of aim control old pick. And I mean, yeah, as you said, Brazil been doing pretty good on those. At least from last round, so why not, right? Like, pick something you're comfortable at when you're cruising through the match.
Also a banger song.
Yeah,
much better than Spy.
Spy actually existed. I will refrain from giving any comments on song taste.
Spy. The map literally just existed, and I'm shocked.
Yeah, actually almost, I think, entirely different roster from the Netherlands era. Well, Brazil actually has the exact same, so that's interesting. So 3 changes in the Netherlands, 0 on Brazil.
Yeah, you pretty much have the main DT roster right now, besides Mistia just not being there.
Yeah.
Maybe, I don't know, playing a visual novel, I don't know.
I would actually
not be too surprised to see him just being like busy with something else and just like, I don't know.
Oh yeah, Jesus. Maybe, who knows? I wouldn't know, so.
It would actually be a...
Back to the map. It's starting. There's sliders. Insane. It is kind of ulti. Oh wait, Nissan's single tapping. Yes, of course he is.
This is 300 BPM.
Ah, yes, that's a very single type of BPM, clearly, as Nissan is showcasing. Meanwhile, Skyrovania actually has very bad egg, actually, in comparison.
Yeah.
Oh my god, I think he, like, overtapped that. So
yeah, he just not locked.
This is
Sky Romania with the break as well.
Looking very good for Brazil already. Two breaks in the seventh ones. Much also, better egg compared to them. Yeah.
The egg is really vital here now.
Yeah. Oh, Nissan does break. But it doesn't matter too much. Like, even with the Netherlands recovering, Brazil still has two FCs and, as you mentioned, much better egg.
Yeah, astronomically better.
Yeah.
Oh, Nissan. Oh, yeah, that's Venture.
Okay. I was about to say, but. It's still looking pretty comfortable, Brazil. They actually need like a little bit of a meltdown already.
Yeah.
We're 2/3 of the way in already. Two FCs.
Okay, Snowpap and many of that just break on that. Same with Korean Maluko.
Yeah, so it's actually only XX Luis that's holding the FC.
XX Luis unleashed.
Oh, Skyrovania misses, and yeah, that's it. It's gonna be 6-0. But now it's all eyes on XX Luis. Can he finish it off with NFC? Because the match is already settled at this point.
Luis, incredible. Cambio do mundo.
Sol Brasil e Penta. And yeah, that's all she wrote. 6-0 for Brazil. Not entirely unexpected. I was expecting maybe Netherlands to take some points, but I mean, Brazil on paper as well.
Yeah. Considering that they took 2 points of France, you might have expected them to take the same amount maybe from Brazil, but Brazil just showed
simply,
a great performance.
Simply wasn't meant to be today.
Yeah. Considering that they didn't even have Mistia, so.
Yeah, and yeah, that's gonna be all from us as well. As far as I'm aware, for Europeans at least, there's not gonna be another match today. I think the unholy 2 UTC match.
The Asians and the Americans are gonna be very pleased with the 2 UTC match between Countryless West and Australia.
Yeah, exactly. I'm pretty sure that's gonna get casted as well. So if you're not from Europe, or have a completely messed up sleep schedule.
Like all of Europeans.
Yeah, just keep 2 UTC in mind and tune into 3WC. But for now, we will we'll say goodbye.
Stop
and
more trolling and.
What do you mean trolling? No, yeah, we'll see you, you know, later, I suppose.
Yeah. All right, goodbye, guys.
See you, everyone.